Right, so this video is all about the factor theorem and how we can use that to help us to factorise cubics. So, first off, if I want to show that x minus 1 is a factor of 4x cubed minus 3x squared minus 1. So basically that's saying that this goes into this exactly. Well, one thing I could do is I could do algebraic division. Just like we did in the last video, I can say x into 4x cubed gets 4x squared times, multiply out, then subtract. Notice I put a 0x there because there is no x term over here. You saw in the last video that's really important to have a 0x as a placeholder there. But anyway, you can see, I've gone through the algebraic division process and I've shown at the end that there's no remainder. So I could then say, no remainder, so x minus 1 must be a factor. There is a quicker and easier way of doing this. It's called the factor theorem. To introduce the factor theorem, I want to take us back to GCSE for a moment. And when you were asked to solve something like this, what you first did is you factorised this. So you wrote this as x plus 4, x minus 4 equals 0. So you split it up into two factors. This is one of the factors, x plus 4, and this is the other factor, x minus 2. Then you said, well, x equals minus 4, or x equals 2. Because when you substitute 2 into this equation, you get 0. Or when you substitute minus 4 into this equation, you get 0. Now, the factor theorem is basically this, but in reverse. Rather than us saying, okay, right, I know what a factor is, therefore I know what a root is, what we're now going to say is, well, if I know the root, then I know the factor. So if I know that when I substitute minus 4 into the equation, I get 0, then I know that x plus 4 must be a factor. And similarly, if I know that when I substitute 2 into my equation, I get 0, then I know that x minus 2 must be a factor. Just the reverse process. So this is the factor theorem. If I substitute a number, here I'm calling it a, if I substitute a into my function and I get 0, then that means that x minus a is a factor. That's the factor theorem. So, let's go back to that question we looked at a minute ago. I want to show that x minus 1 is a factor of this. Well, based on the factor theorem, my a is going to be 1. So if I substitute 1 in here and get 0, then I know it's going to be a factor. So that's what I'm going to do. F of 1 equals 4 times 1 cubed minus 3 times 1 squared minus 1. So that's 4, minus 3, minus 1, that is equal to 0. Therefore, x minus 1 is a factor by the factor theorem. You need to write this sentence, otherwise this is just a bit of maths with no explanation. You need to write the sentence. But there we go. And that's a much quicker, easier way of dealing with that problem. Let's have a look at this problem. Because given that x plus 3 is a factor of this, find the value of a. Well, if x plus 3 is a factor, then that means that f of minus 3, if I substitute minus 3 into the function, I'll get 0 if it is a factor, which I'm told it is. So therefore, let's do this. Let's substitute minus 3 into our function. So 6 times minus 3 cubed minus a times minus 3 squared plus 18 needs to equal 0. Okay, minus 3 cubed is minus 27. 6 times minus 27 is minus, what's that, minus 162, I think that's right. Minus 3 squared is plus 9. 9 times a is 9a plus 18 equals 0. Let's collect about like terms now then. So minus 162 plus 18 is going to be minus 144, I think. Move the 9a to the other side. And so a is going to be equal to minus 144 divided by 9, which I don't know what that is off the top of my head. Which is minus 16. There we go. Right, let's put this together now with the skill of algebraic division, because together the factor theorem and algebraic division is really powerful. It allows you to factorize cubics, which then allows you to sketch them and allows you to solve them. So part A of this question says, show that x minus 1 is a factor of f of x. So all I need to do is substitute plus 1 into my function. So 1 cubed minus 2 times 1 squared minus 11 times 1 plus 12. And let's just check that then. So I get 1 minus 2 minus 11 plus 12 is in fact equal to 0. Therefore, x minus 1 is a factor by the factor theorem. You need the sentence. Part B, hence, using what we just did. Express f of x as the product of three linear factors. So factorize it. Now I know that x minus 1 goes into my function. So I can divide it. And then I can see what will be left over. And then hopefully I can get my other two factors from what's left over. Right, so algebraic division. X into x cubed goes x squared times. Multiply it out. Subtract all of what you get. So minus 2x squared minus minus. So plus x squared will just give me a minus x squared. X into minus x squared goes minus x times. Multiply it out. Minus x times x is minus x squared. Minus x times minus 1 is plus x. Take away. Put my bracket in the wrong place there. Because I've taken away all of that. There we go. Just have to be really careful there. I've got a minus x squared, so I'm times this minus x by that x there. So this minus is coming from here, and that minus is because you take away with the algebraic division process. So, minus x squared minus minus is a plus, so these disappear. Minus 11x minus x is minus 12x. Bring down the 12. And then finally, x into minus 12 goes minus 12. So x into minus 12x goes minus 12 times. Multiply it out. And you can see we get 0, which is what we expected because we already knew that x minus 1 is a factor. But most importantly, we know that we can take our cubic, our x cubed minus 2x squared minus 11x plus 12, and we can now write that as x minus 1 multiplied by x squared minus x minus 12. Minus 12. So we've now got our cubic written as the product of a linear factor and a quadratic factor. But in fact, I can factorise that quadratic just like we do at GCSE. It's going to be an x minus 4 and an x plus 3, I think. Yeah, and there we go. I've expressed my cubic as a product of three linear factors. Right, last example. It says, by first finding a linear factor, fully factorise this cubic. Now, notice we're not given any clues here. It's not like the last question where it says, show that x minus 1 is a factor. We're not given any clues. So where do we start? Well, let's just think about this for a minute. I know that I'm going to have three sets of brackets, or at least one set of brackets, like this perhaps. But I know that the numbers on the end here, these coefficients, when I multiply them together, they're going to go and give me 15. So I'm thinking about numbers that fit into 15. I'm thinking about the factors of 15. What are the factors of 15? Well, 1, 15, 3, 5. And just remember, they could be positive or they could be negative. Using the factor theorem, let's see if any of those work. So if I substitute 1 into the function, what do I get? 1 minus 14 plus 15, I get 2. Okay, so I know that 1 doesn't work. I know that x minus 1 is not a factor. But what about if I tried minus 1? What about if I tried minus 1 now? Well, minus 1 cubed is minus 1. 40, minus 14 times minus 1 is plus 14. That's going to give 28. So that's not a factor either. So you can see, this is far from ideal. This is not a quick, easy, well, it is an easy process, but it's not a quick process. But I know that 1 won't work. What about 3? Let's substitute 3 in now. 3 cubed minus 14 times 3 plus 15. So that's 27 minus 42 plus 15, and that does equal 0. Good. So that means that x minus 3 is one of our factors. So I can now do some algebraic division. So x cubed minus 14x plus 0x squared minus 14x plus 15, all divided by x minus 3. You saw there, I almost forgot my 0x squared, so that would have been pretty bad. You need to remember your x squared here. Right, let's go through the process of algebraic division again then. X into x cubed goes x squared times x squared times x is x cubed. x squared times minus 3 is minus 3x squared. And we're going to take away all of that. That's gone. 0 minus minus, that's a plus. Bring down other two terms. Okay, let's repeat the process. X into 3x squared goes 3x times. Multiply it out. And take away. That's 0. Minus 14 minus minus, so that's a plus. So I'll now get minus 14 plus 9 is minus 5. Bring down the minus, bring down the 15. And then finally, x into minus 5x goes minus 5 times. Multiply out, minus 5 times x is minus 5x, minus 5 times the minus 3 is 15. And you can see taking these away will give me 0, which is what I expected. So I know that my cubic could be written as x minus 3 multiplied by x squared plus 3x minus 5. And then I'm looking at this and I'm thinking about if I could factorise that quadratic. And in this case here, actually, I can't actually factorise that. That's going to have to stay like that. Which is fine, because it just says fully factorised. So this is fully factorised. I can't factorise it any further. So there we go. We're done. So this is a process. You're going to use this quite a lot in terms of using the factor theorem to find one of the factors and then using some algebraic division so you can find the remaining factors. That way you can factorise cubic equations.